Hey there, I'm Christine Collins, and I have for you today 9 ways that you can become just a little bit more creative. And these little tips and tricks will really help you when it comes to conjuring up juicy and exciting new ideas for your content, for your business, or for anything that you may be working on right now. Tip number one is to work on being in what we call the dreamer state rather than the critic state. And I'll explain what that means. So in the NLP realm, we look at three different states of being: the dreamer, the critic, and the planner. Now, our critic state is the one in which we can go in and edit our work and crop and critique, find the errors, find the issues, and all of the problems in something that we're working on. That state is very useful. However, it can also be very inhibitive in terms of conjuring new and exciting ideas because sometimes we automatically assume they won't work. We can find the problems, we can find the holes and the issues and the areas that need to be fixed or examined. In order to really get those out-of-the-box brilliant ideas, you have to place your critic into suspension. You have to really try to shut that part of yourself off and shift into what we call the dreamer state. In the dreamer state, there are no limitations. You have to kind of temporarily suspend logic and your understanding of how things tend to work based off of past experience. This doesn't work, that doesn't work. Get rid of all of that, and for just a moment, allow yourself to believe that anything is possible and to question, what if? What if this were possible? What if I could do this? And then go with that state. Tip number two is to be in what we call in hypnosis the alpha brainwave, or sometimes even the deeper theta brainwave, which is a state in which you are not fully awake, but neither are you asleep. You are in the middle twilight phase where you become suggestible, deeply relaxed, and also very open to new ideas. And your creative mind becomes very active when you're in the alpha brainwave state. So, of course, listening to hypnosis is a great way to get into alpha, but there are many ways that you can do that. You can do that through hypnosis, you can do that through meditation, you can do that through simple relaxation techniques, you can do that through massage, anything that relaxes your body and your mind to move down into that twilight place in between wake and sleep. The third tip is to be open and receptive to taking in art, various forms of art, things that are inspiring, whether that's looking at a painting or a sculpture, reading a book, or watching a movie that's very inspiring. Looking at, watching, and listening to things that actually inspire you and lift you up. So, just as an example, for me recently, I watched a really wonderful program about the planet. And it had a lot of nature and animals and all kinds of very inspiring and uplifting themes. So, whatever that looks like for you, take in some form of art and inspiration that will kind of tickle your creativity and tickle your creative mind to be inspired. Tip number four is to get happy. And whatever that looks like for you, perhaps it's swimming or yoga or getting a massage or having a coffee or taking a walk in nature, whatever that looks like for you, when you are happy and you are releasing dopamine and serotonin, you are at your most creative self. It's very difficult for you to conjure new ideas and to be creative when you are feeling down or worried or stressed out. So, if you can do something that's going to generate the release of dopamine and serotonin, those are our happy hormones in our brain, you are going to be so much more creative and more susceptible to coming up with exciting, juicy ideas. Tip number five is to believe in 6 impossible things before breakfast, aka Alice in Wonderland. So, allowing yourself to step out of the realm of what's possible and step into the realm of what feels impossible, believing in things that are impossible. And you can do that in a number of ways. You can get yourself into some creative fantasy stories, or perhaps you can begin to believe in things that maybe seemed like they were out of reach in the past. You can work on some of those limiting beliefs within yourself about your life, about your work and your business. You can begin to slowly shift from thinking that things are impossible and let them become possible for you. Number 6 is to be consistently open to looking at things from a different perspective. So one way that I do this is that I regularly listen to podcasts or audio or video of people that I know disagree with my opinions on various topics. I force myself, sometimes with gritted teeth, to listen as openly as I possibly can to ideas that contradict what I think and what I believe, because I really like to consistently challenge myself to think about things from a different perspective. And one of the reasons I do this is because it enhances creativity. It gives you a more global, holistic perspective on different topics, and it allows you to approach things from a variety of different angles that you may not have done otherwise. Number 7 is to get enough sleep. This is something that can be challenging for a variety of reasons, so there is absolutely no judgment here, because I completely understand that there are a number of things that can inhibit sleep, including lifestyle things, family things, and also issues with mindset, anxiety, and stress. But to the extent possible for you in your unique circumstance, I encourage you to make it a priority and a focus to the best extent that you can. Because when you are well rested, you are going to be more creative, more capable of coming up with new and exciting ideas, and perhaps most importantly, you'll have the energy to be able to carry out whatever it is that you conjure. Number 8 is to let go of both failure and of success. And the reason for that is because obviously we understand that a fear of failure can be inhibitive to us if we're focused on the possibility of something not working, or getting a poor reception to it from others, or it not going the way that we had hoped. That can prohibit us, but so can success. Sometimes success can be as prohibitive, if not more so, than failure. If you are doing something solely for the purpose of having a specific outcome, whether that's monetary or it's accolades from your peers or from people around you, that can be prohibitive as well, because it may unintentionally pen you into a box where you feel like you have to do things in a particular way in order to maintain whatever that thing was, the financial or the accolades. So don't allow success to inhibit you from branching out, trying something new, and doing something that maybe has not yet been successful for you in the past. That doesn't mean that it can't be a success for you in the future. You can also redefine your concept of what success is, because I think that success, while it can be measured outwardly in various ways, it can also be measured by how much you enjoyed the process of creating that thing and the way you felt as you went through that process. And finally, number 9 is to continuously learn from others, to be a lifelong student, and always be seeking to take in something new from the world and the people around you. The more you consistently expose yourself to new and exciting ideas and things and perspectives, the more creative you will continuously become, and the more fodder you'll have to work with when it comes to creating new things, whether you're writing or creating something artistically or designing videos, whatever realm you swim in, it will allow you to have a never-ending branch of new material coming in that you can use within your work. So I hope you found this to be helpful and fun and insightful. Once again, I'm Christine Collins. I offer content support for intuitive entrepreneurs and help with creativity and focus. If you are interested in learning more about working together or some of the things that I offer for free or as paid services, you can check me out at transformcreate.com. And in the meantime, I hope that you have an absolutely magical and creative rest of your day.